with their talk. This won't hurt much. So give it up for Yelena, please.
This is a Dutch cartoon where someone from IT say, we have data breach, and the nurse and doctor say, what we have not done anything bad, we just share in a closed Facebook page. Now, I'm a nurse, and usual cybersecurity people from infosecurity surprised at what one nurse doing at the cybersecurity conference, but my colleagues are more surprised because they think, oh, we have IT, we have security, so at the hospital we have the best security ever. But that's something what is really wrong. Now, because of my activity, curiosity, and whatever, I became part of Time Discovery. That is a freely organization from volunteers. They try to build awareness at all possible levels, from low level to level of the government. But also I'm a part of the Women in Cybersecurity from Holland, and they did help me to express myself and to share my story. In this presentation, I will talk about how I got to infosecurity, why a hospital, the most interesting target, which problem we face, what are consequences, and what we can do, and the message I want to send. Now, I work most of the time as a consulting nurse, so that means that I come in a lot of different hospitals. So I did see a lot of things. When I came to work, I don't have an own account at that hospital that I can work under that account. So I get account and log in from almost everyone that I work with. Or I did find it on the computer. Hey, look, there is a password so you can use it, or paper written in a book or whatever. And then I realized that I can work on the name from someone else, and that means that I can do things under someone else's name. I can change things and no one will notice that it was me. Then I start to look a little bit more, and when I try to convince them, hey, that's not good what we are doing, then that was not that possible. Because I did work in intensive care, I did work also a lot of with the technical medical devices, and I know what is also wrong and what can go by mistake. Then it was interesting, can we find mistake myself from someone outside of the hospital? I did find that not just security online, but also physical security is not good. So you come to ER or at the hospital somewhere, and then you see the computer data open. You see the fridge for a blood transfusion, here on XP. You see that you can come somewhere. This physical security was also not that good. If you go to the hospital, you can walk. You don't need to even ask everyone or say something. You walk there, no one asks you what you are doing. You can go to some room at the polyclinic, and then you can also say, oh, mistake. And then you can sit at the computer and do some things. Except that, if you go to YouTube or on internet and try to find how some device works, you can find all instruction. But also children, you can work, you can find really every information about things. Another thing was, okay, we are connected, we have a Wi-Fi, how is that? It looks that is not that good. So I find all of the things and I really felt like this. And I was, okay, okay, we have problems, but is that a problem? And I did look to think, why a hospital interesting target? First is you have more victims at one place. And that are not just patients, but also employees and every third visitor that came as a visitor, or that can come to donate, or manufacturer, or everyone who works with the hospital. You have all data online, so every information you can find online. And also you can do damage to the patient, or to the employer or to the hospital sellers. So there are a lot of reasons that you can say, okay, hospital is interesting place to be hacked. We talk about medical data a lot of times. Who wants to have them? By research from HMSS from 2014, end 2014, the work member snooping was the highest level. So people who wants to know who they hire. And they want also to know, does someone have some disease or was sick as a child from cancer or whatever? And they will eliminate. We can say it's not ethical, it's not that, but that is happening and we all know that. Then you have financial and whatever, personal snooping, cyberterrorism, whatever. But what I miss is marketing and insurance. Last time when I was at the Haglu in Luxembourg, we did talk and there was some man from insurance company and he said, we want that data. I know, I work there and we want to know every little thing so we can think, can we make insurance higher? And I don't talk only about healthcare insurance, but also insurance for something else, where you don't need to say anything about your illness, what it was. Marketing snooping is if someone is sick, you can sell them the products because everyone wants to be healthy. So everyone wants to sell their products with stupid story. So when they know that you have some problem, they will bomb you with a lot of products. When you have medical data, except that those things, now we go to criminal act. Born act is $500 at the direct market, at least was. So if you have few medical records, count 10 medical records that you can make, born act is $5,000. You can make a different kind of identity theft for a research and for scientists and a pharma. The data are really high level. Usually for every research you need to pay. You need to ask patient, you need to pay for that. Now they can get at the black market data that they want to have. As I told, insurance, and we have an organized crime that is still stronger and still better and better. Where is security or criminal hacker just one part of the whole part of the organized crime? But there is much more, what we also don't think about. I did mention some things. Discrimination at the work based on information what they can get at the medical data is about disease, about gender, about religion, race, sexual orientation. They can make up future profiles. So when people knows that, I don't like that girl for my son, so I want to see who she is. And when they find that, they will make everything to ruin relationship. It is simple problem, but that is something what we really face and what we have. And I don't want to talk about work or about friends, about things that you don't want to share with everyone. When they find out and when they share, you get pretty much discrimination. The most of things that we think is, hospital medical data. But what we forget all the time, I must say last month I did so two articles that they write a little bit more, same as I say here, that are medical data, but they are all personal data. When you go to the hospital, you must identify yourself, so they have all information about you. They have all the insurance numbers. In America or in another hospital, in countries, they have also your payment data because you must pay the bill. So they have every data about one person, patient. Why I will go to the city hall or somewhere, here I have everything what I want to have and what I can abuse. Also, you have links where you can pay, and that is called third part that came in the hospital. But you also have links from professionals. So when I work, I can log in and I can see all my data. So if someone hacked that, that can see all my data and get email from everyone in the hospital. They can see where I work. So there are a lot of information that I don't want to share with everyone. My personal view about problems with the sites and why I think that security of the site must be much better is that if you have bad sites or not protected site, you can find the log link for the login from employee when you can find that from in many different ways. You can get email from every employee. If you are smart, you can send nice phishing mail and you can take control over the computer, but sadly also over device, because a lot of devices are connected to computers, or they make less PR from some manufacturer of the medical devices is, okay, you can read your private mail using medical device. I don't think why, but okay. So when you have access to the system of the hospital, it's not that you can take control about that, shut down or whatever, but you can also manipulate. So you can change the information that you have on the computer of laptop of devices, but you can change also data, name of the patient, and switch the name and make something else what you want. Because of that, I did make research. Also for me as a nurse, it was simple to find, is it HTTP or HTTPS or for SSL certificate. Also, I did use internet.nl, where you can see about AP4 and AP6, but now also about email security, what is really nice. And I did use Observatory by Mozilla. Dutch hospitals, it was last year, 35% was on HTTP, 65% was HTTPS, but I don't know how much percent has mixed and how much was only HTTPS, so I don't know. SSL certificate, it was 63% they has good, but 37% has no certificate or has bad certificate. And not one has a good IP6 and has no DMARC. US hospitals, by HTTP, 56%, sorry. We are on HTTP, HTTPS 24 mixed, and SSL certificate were a little bit better, 71% was good, but still they has also bad IPFR. Okay, it was nice, I did send some reports. Response, Dutch hospital, I did call to try to make a contact with them, try to find the mail where I can send something. Now that was like, okay, you're a nurse, okay. We have everything under control, or if I did send mail, I never get the answer, or was also we have everything under control. US hospital, I couldn't call because it was a little bit too expensive to call all hospitals, try to find the security department. So I did try a different way to get emails. I said for the 100 hospitals, say more than 200 messages on mail, and 36 I get return and no response from 70. Here in Holland, we did get we did go in the media because I did try to contact the hospitals. There were no response, no reaction, ignored. So we did make article without naming. Telling which hospital, that was only statistical, that much and that much. Now, as follow, it was in the crypto, in a paper, the hospital don't secure their sites. Good. In America, email. I couldn't get it because it was wrong mail. I was not allowed to send to that group. How you think to get any report or any information if you don't allow people to send you mail? Or when I send second information that they will send all reports to the US cert, I get email, get message that I was blocked because they didn't want to hear anything from me. Oh yeah, this, sorry. This was also the cartoon in a media. Volker & Zucker is known, and that was really honored to have it. It looks like when you want to inform hospitals, they don't want to hear it. But there was one CISO in a US hospital, he brought me this. And even I thought it wasn't that so much important research that I did, HTTP, HTTPS, SSL certificate, they can look that self. But okay, I did. And when I get that mail, it felt really good that they find solution and they find the problems with more than 300 external sites and system they fixed. I did talk with him a little bit more, and he find nice ideas, so he's busy to change some things. Next thing, as we told, medical devices, I did work with medical devices, and every time when some medical devices did come, there were a few of us that want to see how it works, and they will pack out and make in. So I did know how they work. One time I had a situation that we had one little baby, and we were there, and at one moment we see that blood pressure going down. It fixed with the pulse, so it's not error, but it's going down. So we were almost ready to give medicament, but something you feel that isn't wrong. So we touched the child and we did feel the blood pressure, and it was good. So we did know that what we see at the monitor and what is with child is not good. So we did take different blood pressure device, and we saw it isn't same. And we find out that the calibration was error, did go down from himself. So I was like, okay, maybe that can happen from outside. Maybe I can, or some hacker can, control device and make that calibration lower. So then we wouldn't see the real blood pressure. Also, there was also another story that we could download the movies, and sometimes Night Shift did download the movies on the PC, but the board came after and they say, okay, that's not good, so we get blocked, so we couldn't go to download. And in few weeks we get a story that one nurse did use medical device, ECG device, to download the movies. And it was, you know, it was a nice story, okay, not technical nurse, catch the tech side of the hospital. And I was like, okay, you can believe it, it's a nice story. But then I find this on Twitter, that you see that ECG device have Game Boy inside of the device because they didn't have a screen. So they did use Game Boy. Undercover, he did make in June last year some first open, so public, hacking of the medical devices. So they make some simulation, and I have a later movie if we have time we can look. So that was the movie. They did hack the pacemaker and ECT, that is inside defibrillator. So they did take control thereover. So when doctor they tried to manipulate device inside the body to make it work, it didn't work. So patient died 3 times. They did a hack infusion pump. So they put a few hundred milliliters in just 15, 20 minutes, and not for more hours of a whole day. And they did hack also insulin pump. Okay, well and not. But they did hack insulin pump by someone who did the drive. So when he get low sugar, he will not die. But if he is driving, he will get dizzy, so he will make accident. And there is a lot of possibility that he dies or someone else. This. We talk all the time MRI or whatever, big devices, as they are a lot important. They are important. But this is one stupid small device. But it's really important for us. If you manipulate that, I can't do anything to save the patient. If someone manipulate that, there are few articles on internet. So if you look just hacking the pump infusion, you can find a lot. So we have problem with devices. Okay, old devices, bad old software. But there is also another problem. because the contracts with the hospitals make that hospital may not do patch, no update, they may not have antivirus, they may not have proxy, but they must be connected on the public internet 24/7. That's something what is not at the hospital, what we cannot blame security department at hospitals. That is contract the manufacturer is. So you see, every time when I look one, I find a lot of more problems. That's not that nice. Even at least for ICS cert, there you can find that every time they say no, not connection 24/7 medical devices on internet. One time I had a discussion with someone from the manufacturer and he tried to push me, no, but it must be online. But what they were afraid if they say, okay, it's not all the time online, that people in the hospital will say, okay, then we don't need to high security because you must pay for that. So that is the another message that I want to say. Also, if medical device isn't 24/7 online, it's not secure and it must have really high level security. Okay, we have everything connected. So we have public connection, computers, medical devices, mobile phone application. We have cloud, and last time is all the time talking as cloud is okay, that's something what is normal. But the highest, one of the first three highest risks from people who work at the hospital, from security, they say cloud is one of the three highest. Last year at the DEF CON was this guy, Dirk Metter. You can find him on Twitter, hashtag WifiCactus, and you can read more about that. He put a lot of pineapples, range 100 meter, monitoring till 14,000 devices. He can monitor every device in the hospital. We did talk about that, and one good hacker say, yeah, but VPN is good. VPA2 is good, so it's secure. 10 days later, we find this. That is also not that safe. The second problem, one of the most problem, are innovation, IoT, smart health. We want to be smart, we want to digital, but there's a micro component, say, whenever the application is described as smart, is vulnerable. Innovation IoT can be abused for collecting the data, all possible data, marketing. If you look this on internet, what happens when you tell the internet that you're pregnant, you can find a talk or article about one talk. That woman did download on her phone everything. From the healthcare apps for the pregnancy, what she must do or whatever. Now she didn't find that one did do good work, but she get lot of marketing, lot of spam mails with selling the products. But we also don't think that IoT and all the innovation can be abused for DDoS attack, because you have little small things that you can use it, but it doesn't need to be attacked to the hospital. If you attack some infusion pump of some IoT that gives some information to us, you can change the function of that, you can manipulate because of that DDoS attack, so you, by accident, you can kill someone or you can harm some patient. Spreading malware of virus, manipulated data is known. Did you know this? Healthcare app doesn't need to do what they say. So it's your own responsibility if you use them. If you say, but it didn't work good, not anyone will say, okay, you are right. It's your problem, it's not their problem. And then I ask myself, do we really need all of them? Did you know this? Most of the healthcare institution And that's not just hospitals, there are also smaller institutions from 10 nursing homes. The physicians, small offices, they don't have security department. They hire someone to take care about technical stuff and site, but they don't know that there is not security included. So they are most of the time pretty open to be hacked. A hospital with more than 200 employees and few hundred patients have someone, sometimes one person, who is responsible for security. Most of the time, okay, he's the security, does it's his problem if something goes wrong. But that people, if they say something, they are most of the time, we don't want to hear it, do your job, do your technical stuff, we don't care about that. So there is also a big problem. IT department, as my colleagues most of the time think, isn't security department. Security department, in my own opinion, must be important part of IT department or different department, and where people need to follow their decisions. They need to have a more influence in making the rules, policy, the products, and they need to be open to communication with another, and security and non-security people. Now, a few jokes about my experience. I couldn't download the Tor. I did download at the computer of the hospital Chrome because I was irritated from slow Internet Explorer, so I couldn't download. I could download the Chrome. I started to download Tor just for the fun, and then I was like, okay, that's too much, so I did stop it. When I changed password, I forgot it, so I called my IT department and I say, okay, sorry, I forgot my password. Thinking he will send me some link. Oh no, what is your account name? Okay, here you have. So if you call from outside, it's social engineering, but at some places I did warn about that, so they changed. So the changing was they send email to that person. Okay, you just did ask for changing the password. Say, okay, don't work, but never mind. If I work somewhere as a consultant nurse, I get also some account for everyone. Forgot how you call it. And then I can get access also to the mails and to everything. Why I need to have access to email as someone from outside from the whole hospital? I don't need it. I don't need to send email. I need to see medical data so I can write what I need to write, and that's it. But I get much more access. Patient with medical records connected to the public internet. Insecure applications for medical records. Then you can put USB, etc. there. As I did told. Oh, sorry. This is application for a medical records. Before we had as a map, so I didn't need to be connected to internet to open medical records. Now I have medical records, you see there. And okay, it was mistake, but I get Google. At medical records, you see here upstairs is client informations. I don't think it's good. USB. Different hospitals. Huh? Why I told it? This is nice. That is account from Twitter from one guy. He said also USB is a problem. But what about charger? Using USB charger, he did hack the computers. I'm sorry, I have no sound. So without cable. Why is that important? It works everywhere, so you can see. Hello, we have that in the hospital too, everywhere, and everyone will okay, a free charge, yes, but okay. Okay, we have we have that WannaCry NotPetya hospital. What I did here just yesterday, that WannaCry couldn't give the documents back. I didn't know that, so I will try to find out what did happen with the NS hospitals in London about that. The consequences harm the patient. There were cancelled operation, the patient need to be removed, whatever. But because replacing waiting, maybe was dead. There is no report that anyone died, but if you want to really find that, that you will need to go to how you call it, begravenisplaats? Cemetery, yes. To see, did someone die on that day, and to find his medical records to see what it really happened. Obstruction of the work of the hospital, financial consequences, losing reputation, whatever, but what we, there are things that we don't know. I did ask a lot of people who know or more something about ransomware, and I say, how I can be sure that they will send to me same data as they were. No one did say, yes, it's true. Yeah, he lose reputation, but I say, can I check it? Yeah, if you don't have a backup, you cannot do it. So when we, sometimes we think maybe they can attack hospital with the ransomware for some another reason and that use it for something. So the most scary things, what we don't, they are what we don't know. Financial consequences for the hospital for the ransomware is where you pay. If you want to back up that healthcare record, $355. The scientist record research, $112. So it's easier to pay ransomware and it's cheaper than to get backup and to clean up all the data what they have. Okay, that was the problem, so we need to get solution and look about solution. Most of us talk building awareness about employee, by employee. But it's not only that. Awareness need to be built also by IT department and security department, that they don't work together, so they, everyone need to wake up and do things. Developers, vendors, but also board and government. By building awareness, we are not, we don't have enough. We need to take action. Because if we know some things, we know, but if we don't do action about that, then we wouldn't get anything. Then I talk about organization, responsible disclosure that need to be paid, in my opinion. Security and privacy by design, and PCI devices don't connect to the internet. This was last year investigation. 68% internal cause of data breach in a hospital. In all public industrials, finance and healthcare, even almost 82% internal cause of the data breach. So if you have employer like this, you don't need anything. Last time I find this. One of the five healthcare professionals have experienced patient data breach. I think that's really alarming. Okay, back to the employer. How you build awareness? I know the technical guy likes to talk and explain to non-technical people everything, technical level, technical language. They don't understand and they don't want to hear it. You lose them in the 2 minutes. We need to understand that usual people, not tech people, are not interesting to learn in private time tech things. They don't like tech, because if they like tech, they will be on tech and not in something else. And they don't understand it. They are more open as everyone else, okay, at work, at the workplace, it's paid, so you can learn them. But before you learn them, you need to make them interested to learn. How you do it? as I said, most of people doesn't think about that. When you work, you have your own personal data on the side of your company. You can log in from home and you can find everything about that. So when they talked to my colleagues about that, they were like, okay, I never thought about that. Then the second things, then you can talk them what can happen. But what they say, you don't need to talk a lot of stories, just few things what everyone knows, remind them. If you go to vacation to Morocco, 2K, if someone stole your identity and do something under your name, they can say at the border, okay, we need to have a talk with you, with the police office. You go to prison and your vacation is not anymore vacation. Just few things. So they're okay. First, they give own data, okay. Remind them what can happen in the short, then they are open. In the third part, you can talk with them what are the problems and how you can fix that. But then, not make serious. Make it simple. I have an example. When you go to the doctor, do you want to know how bacteria that you have in your shelf works? What is chemical and DNA and everything about bacteria? Then chemical things about antibiotics and how that process working, what happened with your body, what can be. Or you want to hear, okay, do that and that. Take antibiotica one or two or three times a day, lie down, drink, whatever. They also don't need technical stuff and an introduction. You can just tell them simply way what they need to do and what they need to care about. That way you make them aware, they find it okay, that's all I need to know, so they will follow that. The second good thing is that you make contact between IT, security department, and employer. Every time will someone be more interesting and they want to know more. Then you can talk with them at a different place and different time and educate them, so you will have a second hand at the department who can take care about small things. When people understand the problem, they will accept the roles. But again, why serious? Why we must make drama and whatever? You can make it nice cartoons. I did show those things to my colleagues, they like it. They did laugh. When you make the posters everywhere in the hospital and change them, yeah, people will laugh, but they will remember that. So that awareness building by developer, innovation and vendor, okay, they want data, but they need to know this. As I said, they need to also know that. That useful medical devices software need to be made this way. So not that someone say you must have that. No, we need to work together. Healthcare, what and why, security, on second place, really, protection, software manufacturer, their production, and IT department need to understand that they are not only just technical anymore, they need to build security and be aware of that. When everyone is satisfied, when everyone say yes, production is selling. But without yes from security, I wouldn't let anything go outside, in production or in selling, whatever. Small part about another thing what we need to have is coordinated responsible disclosure of book bound programs. For the ethical hacker, it's nice passion, work when he can, when he wants, and he can get paid, or she. For hospital, they have online safety. They have almost 24/7 monitoring because people are at home, they want to see, do you have a bug, maybe I can earn money. So they will look. Because hospital cannot pay everyone or anyone to control everything 24/7. Even if they get some things, devices for control, they cannot make it. And this is also nice. It is not, it not make 100% secure, but it make it better. It's not expensive. They can pay them when they find. So when they didn't find anything, you don't need to pay them. and you have coordinator cyst. When I did talk with the CISO from US hospital, he find that really nice idea, and I don't know how far he get, but I hope that he couldn't make it at his hospital. Before that, you need to have someone who will get responsibility to respond, to say thank you, or to say something more. But also, they need to make also the basic things good done. Because when they know that they are make basic things good, they don't need to get reported about that. Security and privacy by design. So that is education what we need to have. By developers, manufacturers and vendors must be pushed to use that software also. And especially smart health and innovation and IoT. I did talk with some innovation, and when I talk about privacy and security, they were like, oh, please let me. I don't care about that. Because I did talk from around, they will never say that to the security people or public, but they think that most of them, I hope that now it's changing better, but that is how it was a year ago. Organization, monitoring, detecting, and reacting of that. Because if you monitor and you detect and don't do anything, you have not done anything. Now you see, password, antivirus, web security, proxy, firewalls, patches, monitoring, email protection. A lot of hospitals, you can send spoof emails. In the name of them, of they receive the spoof emails, sadly they don't react a lot about reports which you mailed it. We need to have a policy. And now we have a different way. But I hope that you can follow this way, that the policy need to make to be made from healthcare professionals, security, and also technical staff, manufacturer who must produce and everything. Make policy together and then go to the government, and government need to back up it. Not that from government come they say it must be done like that. No, you support what professionals say about that. Yeah, we need teamwork. Few messages that I want to send for everyone, especially for the usual average user. Hackers only need to be lucky once, users need to be lucky all the time. Don't put on internet what doesn't need to be on internet. This was really nice video. If you can look, dangerous choices, it say a lot. This is message from the man from I'm the Calvary, and he said hospital didn't like it. So he didn't change something like responsibility based, he liked it. If you can afford to protect it, then you cannot afford to connect it. And what is also one of the most important messages, that you need to build security from the ground. You cannot buy, you cannot say, okay, things, okay, that done. No, you need to build, depend on place where you work and where you are. And one question for you. Do you still feel safe about being at the hospital? Yeah, many people guys, okay, it's safe. So, that was it. How much time I have?
Do you want questions?
You can ask me now or later.
Question anyone?
How much time I have?
50 minutes.
Okay. I would just like to see you. This is Epic. This is APD from America, that some hospital in Holland also use it because they can share all data. Yes, connection with a lot of hospitals. They share millions of documents at a day. But when you go to user, just look this. You have a switch so you can find the hospital. Okay, we find one from Holland. You see that? You get instruction, what is your username? So it's that number. So it's number, personal number of employer. Then you go and look right about pictures. And you get video. Hello. I did with someone here and, oh no, he's not here. It took 30 seconds to find this. If you want to see, this is nice movie about, do we have audio?
There's a table here. Should be a table here. This one.
Yeah, if you don't have a... How I can start to live here?
Thanks.
How I can get out? I don't know why this doesn't work in this video. It's only picture. I will show you a video from the hacking. Sorry. Ah, shit. No. I have a lot of things that I did change and play with. I will do this. I chose this one. Yeah. Just took a time. Why it doesn't work?
Drop the down box above the speakers.
/hackers are doing about it. Thousands of computers around the world frozen.
You can't read any emails, you can't read any files. Basically, your computer becomes a brick.
An ominous message taking over their screens. Your files are no longer accessible. Send $300 worth of Bitcoin.
Sometimes if you pay, you get your data back. Sometimes they just take your money and move on.
A virus known by some as Petya that first took out computer systems in Ukraine has now spread to the U.S. Among those hit, computers in hospitals near Pittsburgh.
She called me and said surgery was canceled because the computers were down.
This after just last month, a worldwide cyber attack by a ransomware virus called WannaCry shut down 65 hospitals in the UK. The virus reportedly affecting not just computers, but storage refrigerators and even MRI machines. This photo, given to a reporter from Forbes, reportedly showing a Bayer MRI hacked by ransomware. The company said it put out a patch for the devices. And last January, Hollywood Presbyterian Hospital in Los Angeles paid out $17,000 after hackers took control of its computers.
It was just odd, though, being at the hospital because all the signs said, you know, do not use the computers. I'm like, what's going on? And they said, well, we got hacked.
Cybersecurity experts now say this problem is getting worse, with hospital computers and medical devices becoming potential targets for hackers.
We went from being prone and prey with no predators to the number one targeted industry last year in less than 1 year. So our relative obscurity is over.
This pacemaker can be wirelessly accessed with that number.
It seems like something conjured straight out of our Hollywood nightmares. Remember that iconic scene from the second season of Homeland?
God, I don't think so. Damn.
That TV fiction, researchers say, could now become fact.
I'm killing you.
The potential threat was concerning enough that some years ago, former Vice President Dick Cheney had the wireless capability on his pacemaker turned off.
Have you ever had a high heart rate before?
We need to intubate.
To combat this problem, doctors, security experts, and government employees recently converged upon the University of Arizona in Phoenix to witness the first ever simulated hack of a hospital. The event was organized by Jeff Tully and Christian Demeff, both doctors here. They're also both self-proclaimed hackers.
When you say a hacker, everyone instantly thinks about darkly lit rooms, hooded characters that are nefariously typing and hacking the Pentagon. There's a lot of great hackers out there. They do good. When they find vulnerabilities in systems, they fix them.
What here is vulnerable to hacking?
Well, anything that's plugged in.
Why are devices like pacemakers or ventilators, why are they connected to the internet at all?
Because there's incredible functionality that can be used to the benefit of our patients. Pacemakers can connect to a device at home that monitors the rhythms of the heart and are able to send that information to doctors. These things are good for patients, and we don't want people turning away from the promise that these types of technology have.
Hence today's simulation.
Do you have any idea what you're in for?
I don't. They've been very secretive with us.
These doctors who have agreed to participate in the simulation have no idea what's going to come through the door.
He's losing consciousness.
I can't feel rhythm right here.
You don't have a pulse. Let's start CPR.
They do not know what everyone around them in this simulation knows.
Do you have his cardiologist on the phone yet?
Three critical patients and the culprit, a massive cyber hack.
This entire bag is gone.
The entire insulin dose.
The whole thing went in? So that was a calcium channel blocker overdose.
Let's get ready to shock. We'll get him up to the ICU. We'll take good care of him. Thank you.
So you had no idea that this was a hack.
I knew that there was a problem with the AICD, but I had no idea it was hacked.
Looking on is Dr. Marie Moe, a security researcher from Norway. She and her team of white hat researchers have figured out how to hack a pacemaker just like in Homeland.
That famous scene from Homeland where the pacemaker is hacked, is that realistic to you?
It is a bit realistic. It's not that far-fetched.
Which is scary for Marie because the pacemaker in her body is keeping her alive.
So, in essence, are you saying that you hacked your own pacemaker?
In a way, I'm hacking my own heart. But the reason I do this is to prove that the security is not implemented well enough.
She buys pacemakers like this one for $500 on eBay so she and her team can hack them. And it's not just pacemakers that are susceptible. Researchers say almost any device that can be plugged in is at risk. And white hat hackers, you know, the good guys, say they can prove this. Watch this insulin pump. It just delivered an authorized dose of insulin. Now watch your screen on the left here. That code is a security researcher hacking into the device, causing it to deliver a second unauthorized dose. The researcher says the bug has since been patched. In San Francisco, Billy Rios takes apart and hacks different medical devices, such as pacemakers and insulin pumps, in his own home.
This device here is an infusion pump. And this pump is going to control the rate of medicine or drugs that's going to be administered to a patient.
With an internet connection and a program he developed, Billy is going to hack into this bedside infusion pump.
These pumps have a firewall that's there, but it's very easy to turn off. And then once the firewall is turned off, we're actually going to connect to the pump itself and send it command. If this were connected to a patient, it would dump all the drugs into a patient. We're connected to the pump network over Wi-Fi, so you could be 1,000 miles away. You could be at a Starbucks, or you could be in a hotel, or you could be in another country. So it's almost as if the pump has a life of its own.
Why is it so easy to hack healthcare?
Healthcare is often running on very old, unsupported systems like Windows XP that don't even get patches anymore. Hospitals tend not to invest in qualified security personnel. About 85% or more of the hospitals don't have a single qualified security person on staff.
When a medical device is expected to live in the field for 30 years, the underlying software components are only expected to live, you know, in some cases, 2 years to 10 years. So there's a big mismatch there that we have to rectify and reconcile.
AdvaMed, the industry association for medical device manufacturers, tells ABC News in part the medical technology industry's chief priority is patient safety, and medical device manufacturers take seriously the need to continuously assess the security of their devices in a world where the risks, no matter how remote, evolve. And the FDA, which regulates medical devices, told us cybersecurity risks are constantly evolving, and the FDA has been working diligently to address medical device cybersecurity in all phases of a product's lifecycle.
Open the chest up and this neck bleeds.
Back at the simulation, these doctors are frantically working to keep their mock patients alive.
This has gone from worrisome to potentially lethal really quickly.
In the final test of the day, everything that could go wrong does. A patient with a pacemaker, it's been hacked.
Making first incision?
Yeah, I feel the ICD.
Can pacer leads cut?
That's his native activity right now.
Okay.
All of the pretend patients in this simulation, even the surgical dummies, live thanks to these doctors. And while there aren't any known cases of illicit hackers manipulating somebody's pacemaker, Jeff and Christian are taking no chances.
You guys ever look at each other and think, you know, it's not bad for a couple of hackers who've gone on to perhaps save a bunch of lives here.
I think our parents are just happy that we're not in jail.
Thank you, doctor. Good job. Oh. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
They're going to want to go talk to you. No. I love you, but no.
Maybe next time, Jeff.
Okay.
Although, if these hacker doctors succeed, perhaps there won't have to be
a
next time.
So, scary? Yeah, that was just part of short telling the problems that we have. But as you could see, I try to look one thing and I find few more things. So we really need to be aware that hospitals need more security and need help. How you can convince the medical staff, doctors and nurses? I have some kind of encrypted message for them that you can share with them. Then you can say only the treatment of the patient you make based on the results. The results of a diagnostic. The treatment you make based on diagnostic. Diagnostic you make based on results. If someone can manipulate the results, you get wrong diagnostic, wrong treatment. You don't need to tell them what you think that can happen because you don't know system, you don't need to tell them. Let them think. And then you say, think what kind of results I can manipulate, and I can manipulate everything, but what are things that are dangerous that they can use, that when you make decision to give some medicaments, then you can kill them or harm them forever. So with that, I would like to close. And I hope that you get enough information to think. And also, I hope to work with this and help making security in hospitals better. Thank you.
Okay. Any questions for Yelena? And where's the cube? Okay. Any questions? None?
No.
I have a question, but it was pretty much answered in the presentation. Sad to say that this has been common knowledge by security experts for more than 10 years. And I have to be honest about this. I've not seen it move in 10 years.
I know.
And the main reason we found up till now is not the doctors, not the nurses. It's upper management and the directors of the board. As long as they don't feel any pain in their wallet, they don't give a shit.
What I want to do, and I try to do, because that I send that encrypted message that you can share with private or professional with nursing, I want to make movement from inside. When I talk with the nurses and with the doctors. When I talk with the doctors from intensive care or ER or whatever, and when I tell them, but I know what I can tell them, and I will never share that in public, so because someone can abuse it. When I tell them what we can do, people who know them, I said, you want to prove? No, 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 I believe you, because you don't say something if you don't. Every problem that I said, I get proof. Not from one side, but for sure from 3 to 5 or more different persons in the different sides of the world that is the problem. So if I can make the movement and explain to the medical staff what are the problems, the answer is, if we can show that to the board as a proof, I will close the department. My only decision is responsible is to close the department. I cannot work with devices that I cannot trust. I cannot work with the computers and put things online and digital if I cannot trust them. I cannot work without being sure, because sometimes when you see the result, I must do something, but you know what is consequences if you give some medicaments. Because if that result isn't real, I will kill someone. And no matter that you can say someone else make it, I did it. That's what you have most. For sure, at intensive care and ER, you have that high level responsibility of the life. And if you came behind that something like that happened, you will never feel good about that anymore. Even you know that someone else make it, I give that medicament. I made the order for that. So if I can make that movement, trust me, the board will make decision. Okay, we make money, but also organization. Organization is, I think, 70-80% of making security better, on better level. We need high level of tech security, so it doesn't mean, okay, we make some organization better, we don't need. We still need that, so that's not the point. But with good organization, you make difficult to criminals to hack, and you need to have someone who have really high knowledge about everything to can break in.
And on that bombshell, I'd like to end.
Yes.
Jelena, people, thank you so much.